Hey folks, my name is Confidence and I am a developer advocate at Cloudflare. Today, I'm really excited to let you know that Rust is now a fully supported language for building apps on Cloudflare Workers. We know you love building fast, safe, and performant applications, and it's our mission to provide you with the technology you need to build the best apps. So we're introducing Workers RS, an amazing set of tools to help you build worker apps powered by Rust. This is all new and we'd love to get your feedback. So if you have a suggestion or two, feel free to leave us a message. Now, for a quick demo, I'll show you how to build and deploy your first Rust worker. Are you ready? Imagine you've been traveling frequently and you want to keep track of the cities and the countries you visited. So let's build a worker app that is going to help you keep track of the cities and countries you visited. For this iteration of the application, it's going to be completely headless. And this means that we interact with the application making HTTP requests. And of course, like I mentioned earlier, switching over to my computer right now, all of this is going to be powered by Workers RS. So if you haven't visited this repo, go check out github.com/cloudflare/workersRS and make sure you leave a star over here. So let's switch over to my editor and we can actually start building this application together. All right, so the first thing you need to have installed, of course, is the Rust toolchain. You need to have Cargo installed. If you don't already have that installed, you can Google on how to do that for your particular operating system. Once you have all of that installed, the next thing you need to do is add the cargo generate subcommand, which you can have installed by typing cargo install cargo generate. I already have this installed, so I'm going to skip this step. Then using cargo generate, you can start by creating your workers from a template we provide. So to do that, it's going to be cargo generate cloudflare/workersRS. And once you hit enter, you have a couple of templates to choose from. You can use the template with the Axiom library. You can start from a simple Hello World template, or you can start from a template that uses the HTTP router. So we're going to be using this for this video. And I'm going to just call this Rust Cities. All right, and we have the project created, so we can see the into Rust Cities. All right, and we can clear up all of this and we're good to go. Now, before we actually get building, we need to set up some dependencies. We just have one, by the way, which is going to help us handle JSON input from the HTTP endpoint. We're going to be using sed for this. So I'm going to do a quick cargo add sed. All right. And we have sed added. Then we also need to set up a KV storage to store cities along with the countries, or maybe the other way around. We store countries and then the cities in the countries. So let's set up the KV storage. So this is going to be npx wrangler KV namespace create, and then the name of the KV storage. In this case, I'm just going to be calling this cities. So let's go ahead to create cities. All right, and I don't think that worked, so I'm just going to retry it. All right, and now we have that created. So what I'll do is jump over here and have the configuration copied. Let's copy over the configuration, open up the project in your favorite IDE, and let's search for the wrangler.toml file. So here, what I'm going to do is create an entry for KV namespaces and paste in the configuration we copied from the terminal. So this is going to be KV namespaces. This is going to be an array. And I'm just going to paste in the binding that lets us connect to the KV namespace. Now, to actually run this application, you already saw the lib.rs file. This is the entry point into the application. What I'm going to do is open up a terminal, and then we can run the npx wrangler dev commands to get everything going. So let's open up a new terminal, and I'm just going to do npx wrangler dev. And what this is going to do is it's going to compile the Rust project and then save it on a port that is open on my computer. And the default is 8787. As you can see, we have 8787 picked. And of course, this also comes with our KV namespace configured, so it makes it possible for us to read and write to the KV storage. All right, so this looks good. Now, what we can actually go on to do here is start building the application. The way I want this application structured is that we're going to have two routes. The first route is going to allow users post a city to a given country. So maybe they visit, so for instance, they can make a post request to /France and then pass in Paris as a city, and that is going to get saved in the KV storage. Then the second route is going to be a get request. So you make a get request to /France, and then it responds with Paris as a city saved in France. So that's just the general overview of how we want this application structured. So let's start building. What I'm going to do here is I am going to make a few changes to the app. So this is going to be request instead of HTTP request, and this is going to be response. And I think I'm going to delete everything else we have inside of this block. All right, now we can actually start building. So the first thing I'm going to do here is create a router. So this can be let router equal to router new. All right, and that's going to create a router. And then we want to return the router. So this is going to be router. All right, and run. We want to pass in the request and the environment, and we can do a quick await here. All right, so now we can start defining the routes in our application. The first route is going to be a post route to the /country name path. So this is going to be .post sync. For the path, this is what the path pattern is going to be, /country. All right. And for the handler, this is going to be an anonymous function that takes a request and the context and handles it. All right, so this is what the body looks like. What we want to do in this function is we want to figure out what the country name is, as well as the city that is sent as a post request to this route. So for the country name, that's actually pretty straightforward. We can grab it from the request context. So this is going to be let country equal to ctx.param, and we can grab that from the country key, which is going to be in the request route. So this is going to be country, and this returns an option so we can unwrap it. All right, so that gives us a string. Next, we also want to grab the country from the request body. And since this is going to be a post request, we need to handle JSON data. So let's go use sed to handle all of that. So let's use sed, and from sed, we want to import deserialize and serialize. All right, we want to import those to help us. Then we can head back here and make use of it. So let's define a struct for a country, which is going to be the shape of the JSON input this endpoint is going to accept. So let's do that. But before doing that, we need to add a few traits. So this is going to be derive, and this is going to have the deserialized trait, the serialized trait, and we can also add debug, which makes it printable. All right, so let's define a struct, country. And country is simply going to have a city that has a type of string. All right, that looks good. And now we can take all of this data and pull out the city from the request body made as a post request to this endpoint. So this is going to let city equal to request.json. We convert the request body into JSON, but we need to tell it what the type of the JSON is, which is why we defined a country struct. So this is going to be of type country. All right. And now what we're going to do next is we are going to await this. And then we can grab the city field from the country, which is going to be a string. So I am going to console log this just so we know we're getting the right data to print it to the console so that we can ensure we're on the right path here. So this is the console.log. What I want to do is I want to print the country and also the city. And this is going to be country and city. All right. And because this function needs to return a response, I'm just going to return an empty response just for now. So this is going to be response empty, and we should be good to go. All right, it looks like we need to make requests mutable because we're trying to convert the body into JSON. So I'm just going to jump to the line here and let's quickly make this mutable. All right, that looks good. So we have the application running here. Now I'll create a new terminal so that we can interact with this endpoint. So this is going to be call, we can make a post request to the path. This is going to include the JSON body, which in this case is just city equal Paris. And then we're making a post request to the endpoint where we have the application running, and then including the name of the country. So France is going to have a city of Paris. That's pretty straightforward. So let's make this post request. We don't have anything as a response because we set the response to empty. But heading back here, you can see that we have a log, and this says that the country is France and the city is Paris, which is exactly what we want. So now that we're pulling those interesting data out, we can actually have this saved in our KV that we configured earlier. So to save that in KV, we're just going to like put it into KV and return a response. So let's do that. So this is going to return match. I'm going to use a match pattern to handle the edge cases if there's an error in trying to put this into KV. So this is going to be match ctx.kv. We want to access the cities KV. And what we want to do here is we want to put the country and we also want to save its value, which the value in this case is going to be city, and we can execute this and we can await the execution. And this is going to return a result. So for the OK value, we actually don't care what the OK value is, but if this goes through, we simply want to return a response telling the return a response that just prints out the city name. So this is going to be response, the OK, and this is going to be city. But if there's an error, we don't care what the error message is, we are simply just going to respond with error. So this is going to be response the error. The error message, we can say something like bad request. And for the status, we can do something like 400. All right, so I think this looks good. Now let's go test this out. I'm going to head back to the terminal and let's make a post request to France. All right, so you can see that that went through. That was like really fast. And we have the name of the city sent back to us as a response, which in this case is Paris. So we have the post route completed now. Let us set up the get endpoint, which is going to allow us to read a city giving the country name or fetch the city of a particular country. So I'm going to head back to the IDE here and I'm going to set up a get route with get async. And this is going to be very similar. I think I need a bit more space here. So I'm just going to get us some space over there. So head back, and for the pattern, this is going to be /country. All right, we also need to set up the handler function. All right. And similarly, we want to grab whatever the country is. I think we already have this, so I'm just going to copy that and we can head down and I paste that in. So we're grabbing the country from the path. Then we want to take this information and go search the KV storage for. So to do that, it's actually really similar to what we did earlier. So I'm just going to return a match, which is going to help us handle the edge cases. So this is going to be ctx.kv. Cities. And we want to do a .get operation given the country name. All right, and we convert it to text. And we await all of the operation. All right, so we are going to get an option here, which is either going to resolve to the country name or the city name or nothing. So this is going to be some city. If we do get a city back, I just want to return a response with the city name. So this is going to be a response dot okay city. All right. Else, if we don't get anything back, I'm just going to return something like country not found. So let's do response error. Message is going to be country not found. And status is going to be something like 404. Yeah, I think that's good. Okay, so we have this done. It looks like we have some errors. Oh, I see. So here, I need to add that, and I think we're good to go now. Okay, so heading back to test this out. I'm just going to make a call request to the application and then /France since we already have this saved in the database. So give this a go and you see that we have France retrieved from KV and returned as a response to this endpoint, which is exactly what we want. Now, if we try to create a request for a country that doesn't exist, so let's say /India, for instance, we get the response saying country not found, which means our error handling works as expected. And now that this is done, we can actually go to deploy this app. So I'm going to head back here, close the server, let's clear this out. And we can run npx wrangler deploy. All right, and this is going to have our app deployed. All right, and we have the app deployed to this URL. So it's usable by everyone on the internet right now. So we can take this, I'm going to take this and let's head back to the other terminal and let's make a post request to /France, but this time we're going to be using the live version. So this is going to be post /France. I hope that's correct. And we have Paris returned, which means the response was everything work as expected. Now I'm going to head back to the browser and let's make a GET request from the browser to /France. And you see we have Paris returned as a response. So all of this works and I'm really excited for all of the cool applications that I know you're going to be building using Workers RS. So please go ahead to start building applications powered by Rust using Workers. And of course, if you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section. And if you have suggestions or feedback for the team, please be sure to share them with me. Awesome. So that's all for today's video. We're going to continue building this application. We're going to add a UI and build it all out. So stay tuned for future videos showing you how to build Worker apps using Rust. I'll catch you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.